All right, so as you probably already know, the starter on the left engine quit working. And so we have gone in here and opened it up. The starter, you can see the, maybe you can see the two mags here on both sides. The starter goes right in between. It's a little hard to see, but the starter goes in between. So we've gone in and taken the starter out, and the what ended up happening is we had an extra starter that we got with the airplane, and so we took that starter and put it on the airplane. We weren't real sure about the status of it as far as whether it was in good condition or not, but it ended up it's not. It doesn't work either. So what we have done is we've got the original starter off of the airplane. We've ordered two new starters, and we're sending both of these back as cores. And so today we should be getting the new starters in so that we can get one put back on the airplane and see if it's going to work. So hopefully we'll have the airplane going again here by the end of the day. All right, we got our starters in. So we've got two of them here, and we're going to be taking them and putting them on the airplane here shortly. So hopefully we'll have this thing ready to fly again by the end of the day. All right. So we have the starter here. So we're going to get this thing ready to put back on the airplane. Get all of the paperwork set aside. All right, so we've got a new gasket for the thing. So we're going to use that on the airplane. So we're going to set that aside for right now and get the paperwork out of the way. All right, so what we've got to do right now, the way this thing works is it has a clutch in here in the centerpiece that actually pops out when it spins and locks into the engine. It's a little hard to get the camera in to actually show much of that, but this thing basically just spins, slides out, locks in, and then when its engine cranks up, it backs off and lets loose. So not a whole lot complicated. It's supposed to, I think it's also supposed to slip if it's got a clutch in it, it's supposed to slip if you get a hydraulic lock. I guess I don't really worry too much about that because I'm going to pull mine through by hand before I crank it up, even though there are people out there that say not to do that. So then what we've got back here on the back is we've got our positive and negative. The positive line runs into this guy. So we're going to be putting all of this back on there so that we can hook up all of these pieces. So we'll do that and get this put back together, and then we'll get it back on the airplane. All right, so what we've got to do now is we've got to get this little guy on here. Let's see. I'm trying to remember how this went on here. We had this on, and then this, but I think what we had first is we had this guy locked on here. Let's see. think what happens is this guy locks down on here, and then we lock the cable down on top of this. I'm gonna have to grab a nut out of the old one. Now, this thing clocks, so we're gonna have to put it in with these two lugs at the bottom, because the positive feed comes out of here and goes over to the firewall. So we'll tighten that in, and let me grab another nut. All right, and then what happens here is this guy comes up in here like so. And then, but I think, trying to remember, because it's going to have to go, I think it, well, it can't go that way, so just have to bend it around where it has to get. So then we're just going to take this guy. I don't know if we'll have enough lug on this one to make this work. So, this one's a little different than the old one. Not terribly different, but it does have, so I think what we're gonna do is remove that. We've already got the nylon washer in there. Now, let's put a lock washer
Daddy.
Yes, sir.
Mama needs you to do something over there.
All right, I'll be there in a minute.
I'm not going to give me 88 Robux.
Give you what? Yeah, I'll see you in a minute. There's no internet over here. Alright, so we're going to clock that like that. And we're going to put you in here. You on there. You there. So that is on, and we're going to put this guy back on here. Grab a screwdriver. That goes on there like that. So now we are ready to put this back on the airplane and hook everything up. So we'll get the gasket off of the other starter because it's still stuck to the crankcase. So we'll get that off and then we'll put this thing on the airplane. All right, so here's our test. So, Larry, do you remember where the master is?
I don't know what
you're for. It's the big square knob on your right hand side underneath the throttle. Just make sure you get the master and not the gear. All right, pull it out and you should hear everything start. All right, and then there's a little flip door to your right hand side. You got it where the two buttons are, and just hit the starter button. Just bump it. So, all right, turn it over one full. Good deal.